Leveraging OpenAI's API keys in SwiftUI projects adds a remarkable layer of functionality and versatility to your development endeavors. This dynamic combination empowers developers to effortlessly integrate real-time data, services, or features into their SwiftUI applications. OpenAI API keys enhance the overall capabilities of SwiftUI projects. Today, we are going to build a project that creates images from prompts and use a GitHub repo to streamline the integration. And if you'd like to learn more about how to use OpenAI's APIs, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. It's rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, today, we are going to generate some cool images with the OpenAI's API, and we are going to use this particular GitHub repository. It's from MACPAW, and MACPAW/OpenAI. Here is the link, as you can see. Well, this is for the README. Well, let me just shorten that. GitHub.com/MACPAW/OpenAI. And this is a really fantastic repository that we are going to use today. And I have already prepared a demo, well, a starter project, not a demo project. This will be the demo project, but this is a starter project. And actually, this is what we are going to be building. It's basically giving a prompt, and here we are going to have the image created once we tap on the create image. So let's just check this out, how it's working. Let's see, a cat sitting on a couch, or whatever you would like. Let's just create that. It will take a while, and then we are going to get that image back as a link preview. As you can see, it's just generating it. There we go. We have a cat sitting on a couch. Really, really nice. If we click on it, we are going to be taken to the actual image. And yeah, this is what we are going to build out. Let me just take you through the starter project. And feel free to go ahead and pause the video and copy out the code that we have over here if you need to. Okay, so here we have the link preview. It's a UIU representable. You know what we saw previously. We don't have anything like this for SwiftUI just yet. So we are using the link presentation framework to create a that view with that URL. And basically we have the keys right over here inside a static function, a static struct. I'm not going to reveal this. I'm going to show you where you can get your own key. Of course, this is a best practice to add your keys onto the client code itself. OpenAI highly suggests that you store these keys on your own servers. So if you'd like me to cover a tutorial on that, let's just meet 100 likes on this video. And if we get it, I'm going to create that video also on how to store your own API keys on your own server. Okay, so for convenience of this tutorial, we have that right over here in this folder/file. Now, it starts off with a navigation stack because I do need the navigation title, and it's just going through the content view. And the content view is really, really straightforward, as you can see. It's just having a state variable as a prompt, a text field inside the list for that prompt, X is vertical, so we're just going to accommodate itself to the text that we type it in, and then list style insert group because I found it much more nicer, and the toolbar item of a button that will create that image. That's it. Everything else we are going to type out today. So let's get started. First of all, we need to add the OpenAI GitHub repository. So let's just add that as a Swift package. So just going to copy that URL, going back to Xcode and select the project, package dependencies, click on the plus button over there and paste that in the search field, add package, and add package again. There we go. We have the package added, current version 0.2.5. Okay. SwiftUI developers cherish my mentoring sessions at rebeloper.com/mentoring for their unparalleled guidance and expertise. As a seasoned mentor, I provide personalized and insightful support that caters specifically to the unique challenges faced by SwiftUI developers. Through these sessions, developers gain a deep understanding of SwiftUI, best practices, advanced techniques, and efficient problem-solving strategies. With a focus on practical insights and real-world application, these sessions have become a go-to resource for SwiftUI enthusiasts seeking to master their craft and stay at the front end of iOS development. Check it out at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So next up, we want to create some sort of a store where we can handle all of our calls to OpenAI. And for that, we are going to create an observable object that we are going to use inside our view. So let's create a new file. And it will be a Swift file. Let's click on next and let's call this image store. Okay, let's create that, and let's import OpenAI. There we go, and let's create that class. So class image store observable object. We need this observable object with quiz because we are going to store here the array of images that we might get back as a result from our prompt. So let's have that published variable at published var images, and those will be of type image result. This comes from our OpenAI dot URL result, and currently it's an empty array. Now this URL result will have the actual URL to the image that has been created for us, so we can just display it however we'd want to. Okay, so next up, this image store does need our, you know, API key from OpenAI. We are going to give it with a protocol, and let's just add the protocol right over here, var OpenAI client. We are going to create this client, you will see in just a second, but this has to adhere to the OpenAI protocol. OpenAI protocol, there we go. Again, from the OpenAI Swift package that we added. Now, because, you know, I did not give it a default value, I did not set it as an optional, we need to create an initializer for our class. And OpenAI client, OpenAI protocol, save. Yeah, the initializer has been created successfully. Next up, we want to grab the images for a certain query, and that query will have that prompt you will see in just a second when we create that on the button of create images. So we are going, and this goes into background, therefore we want to move it onto the foreground when it's done. So we just say at main actor func, we just call this images because it's just going to give us back the images, and we are going to have a query. And this will be an images query, again, from the imported framework. This will be asynchronous. And let's see what we have to do to get those images. First of all, I want to clear all the images from that array. So we are just going to start off with a clean array. So remove all. And then this will be an asynchronous throwing function. So I'm going to add it into a do catch statement. So do catch, just going to print out the errors, localized description. Of course, in a production ready code, please make sure that you move this error up the chain to the view itself and then present it inside an alert. Anyway, if there will be an error right over here, currently it's just going to be presented as a console log. Okay, next we want to actually grab the images. So we're going to get a response. So let response. Response, and that is try await, because it might throw and we have, it's an asynchronous function, we have to await for it. We just call upon the OpenAI client the images function, and you can see here is the one with the query, and the query will be the one that we added into our function. And once we get the response, we want to get the images from that response. It's from the data. So we just say images, the published variable equals response dot data. And that's how we populate our published variables with those images. Now, that's it. Now it's time to add all of this into our content view. So as you can see, first I have some notes right over here. We have to import OpenAI. That's of course obvious. And then we need to create our store. Because we are having only this view, I'm just going to create it as a state object right over here. And I'm not going to just move it anywhere else. It's just going to live right over here. Otherwise, of course, you just create it as a state object, maybe set it up as an environment object and access it as an environment object in other views. But yeah, long story short, let's create that state object right over here. And it will be a private var store equals. Now, it's going to be an image store. We're going to use the initializer with an OpenAI client. As you can see, it needs an OpenAI protocol. Okay, but what is that? Well, we can just give a protocol as the OpenAI with an API token. Now, this needs to be a string, of course. You should not, ship this with your client application. Please grab it from your server. For now, it's inside keys.openai API key. Now, where can you get this API key? Well, if you go to, in my other browser right over here, so platform.openai.com/api-keys. This is where you can find your own keys. If not, first of all, you have to sign up. And if you don't have any keys created, then just click on create new secret key and that will be it. Make sure that you save it somewhere safe, because afterwards you will not be able to access it. And also, just a heads up, each of these profiles that you create on the platform of the OpenAI, you need to you are required to give your phone number, so you get $5 a credit extra. Of course, this phone number has to be unique. You cannot create multiple of these accounts, otherwise you won't get those. You know, you're not going to get multiple $5 for free as credits that you could use. Now, here is where you get your key. Let's get back to our Xcode project. And now we have our store set up. Now, currently, we just have the prompt and it will be saved into this state variable. Now, what about the images? You already know that the image store does have an array, a published array of images. So let's check if that is actually empty or not. If it's empty, we are going to present a content unavailable view, which is available as of iOS 17. So let's just start typing this out, and I will just make a little bit more room over here so we can see it better. So if not $store dot images is empty, then we are going to present the images. Otherwise, else, we are going to present a content unavailable view with a title and a system image. Let the title be no image, system image. I'm going to just copy it out from down here. Let's just paste it in there so we don't have any typos. And then for the text, just to be short on time, I'm just going to copy out the text also for the description. So please enter a prompt to create an image. Okay, that's our view that is going to be presented when there are no images available on the store. What if we do? Well, we are going to prompt for one image, but you could prompt for more. Therefore, I'm going to have this as a for each. And the data will be $store.images. Okay, the ID, let's just have also the ID is self. So self, because this is not identifiable. We're going to get back an image with a small I image in. There we go. And now we want to you know, present that image inside a link preview. Now, we want to make sure that we do have a valid URL. So let URL string, come on, string equals image wrapped value dot URL. There we go. Otherwise, we are going to set this string as an empty string. Now, of course, this just make sure that it is a string. We also want to make sure that this is a valid URL. So if let image URL equals URL string, and then we just go URL string. Of course, you know, this might not be a valid URL, it's just a URL. We want to make sure that it is by adding it as a UI application dot shared dot can open URL, and we are going to set that as the image URL. There we go, URL. There we go. It's not auto-completing. Okay, so if all of this is okay, let me just see. Yes, the error went away. So if we do have a valid URL that can be opened, then we just present it inside a link preview that I have created. Again, take a look at it use it on your own, or just, you know, at this point, you can present this URL in any other way you prefer. Just say, just add that image URL. Let's just have an aspect ratio of fit. Content mode is fit. Now, if there isn't any image URL, maybe it's corrupted or something like that, we just say, we just present the text of that URL string with a foreground style of secondary. Okay, so yeah, just so you know that, okay, this is the URL string that actually could not be converted into a URL, therefore we could not fetch it into that link preview. Okay, so that's how we present it. How do we actually create the image? And this is our final step on right over here. It's going to be an asynchronous function, so let's create a task for that. And we, first of all, we need to create a query as you previously saw, and then just add that onto our store. So first of all, the query. Query equals images. Yeah, images query. And we are going to give a prompt. N is the number, how many images we want, and the size. Now, you could just go with the default values. I'm just going to use the prompt robot over here, set the N to 1. So I want to make sure that we have only one image that we are returning. And for the size, 256 by 256. Of course, you might have multiple. And to go ahead and take a look at the documentation on the actual GitHub repository for the size options that you have. I've chosen the smallest one, so, you know, for these tutorial purposes, that's perfectly fine. Now that we have our query, we want to grab the store and add like store and set the images with that query. So query. And if you remember, this will actually populate the store's images published variable, which in turn will just populate our view with the storage and all of that stuff. Okay, so enough of coding. Let's build and run and let's see how this looks like. And hopefully I built, coded out everything correctly. Basically, that's it. That's how easy to use this GitHub repository. So nuts. So let's give a prompt like dog sitting on a couch, because I'm not that creative today. So let's create that image. Let's just wait a little bit till we get that response. And any second now, we should get that image. There we go. It's loading it. There we go. A dog sitting on a couch. Really, really nice. Now, if you did like this tutorial, go ahead and also check out rebeloper.com/mentoring when you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. And if you, of course, this needs to be paid. And if you want to add a paywall into your own application, go ahead and check out this video right over here.